So the champion's sister was a Grey Warden.
Yes, but that's not the connection you're looking for.
Isn't it? The involvement of the Grey Wardens makes perfect sense. And the champion's companions? Meryl, Aveline, Isabella? That Warden Anders?
Don't remind me. I introduced them.
We thought they all came from Ferelden together, but now it makes sense. Motive and opportunity.
It's still not what you think.
Then I need to hear more.
Unless you've already decided. I can always go if you don't need me anymore.
Tell me what came next.
I'm gonna stop right here. Thanks, guys.
The treasure we found in the Deep Roads made us a fortune. The champion moved up in the world. Literally. Bought a mansion in Hightown. Everyone knew who she was now. Even the Viscount was taking notice. The Grey Wardens left Kirkwall. It was months before we learned Bethany survived. 3 years later, the Kunari still hadn't left. The Kunari insisted they were waiting for their ship. But some of us knew better.
Hello everyone and welcome back to another amazing episode of Arcemise Arcade playing Dragon Age 2. I know I was kind of abrupt on the ending of the last episode, but that's because I wanted to start this one fresh with the beginning of Act 2.
Was not meant to be permanent. There are concerns. The Kunari influence is no longer contained.
Was it ever? Kirkwall has tension enough between Templar and Mage. But these Kunari, they sit like gargoyles waiting for Maker knows what, and everyone goes mad around them. Nearly 4 years I've stood between fanatics. And now, this.
Don't keep us in suspense.
Leave us. Meredith at my throat, Orsino at my heels, and a city scared of heretical giants. Balance has held because the Kunari ask for nothing. Even the space in Lowtown was a gift to contain them. But now, the Arishok has requested you. By name. What did you do?
Nothing?
I can't help it if I make an impression.
Apparently not. I remember how you helped my son. It seems you are meant to have influence above your station. Speak to the Arishok. Give him what he needs to keep the peace. Can you do that for Kirkwall, Sirrah Hawk?
Well, what's going on?
I've seen hate for them, but I haven't heard anything major in years.
Zealots are bravest where their lies can't be argued, behind closed doors. Chantry leaders see Kunari beliefs as a challenge, not an attack. But the message gets muddled among casual adherents. I'm certainly not equipped to argue the fine points of faith.
Yeah. How is your son?
He's been kind to Seamus.
He is his own man. But your actions tempered him somewhat. He's not so angry at the world.
That's probably good.
I may not agree with him on many things, but I am proud of what he is becoming.
That's good, man.
The Kunari usually arrive as conquerors. Odd that this has gone on so long.
Very, and I have no interest in antagonizing them. That is partially why I suffer being a messenger today. A treaty exists, and it has been honored. Although...
You have doubts?
They claim they're waiting for a second ship. But it has been 3 years. They want something else.
Sounds like you'd be better off without this headache.
They will not leave, and we don't have the resources to force the issue. At least, not in a way that would leave the city intact. If they had come to conquer, I suspect they would have done so.
This is the last one. What does he actually want?
Any idea what I can expect?
None. Honestly, I don't think I've heard two direct words from the Arishok. Other than his rather deliberate phrasing of begone. If you think his asking me to notify you of this is strange, well, you would be right.
I'm no diplomat, but of course I'll help.
I'm willing to assist.
Well, that is an attitude this city has lacked for a long time.
Yeah.
Appease the Arishok. Take his demand and let him return to dormancy. As awkward as this has been, it is better than the alternative. Make... What a mess.
Indeed. Alright, now for a proper introduction. Hello everyone, welcome back to another awesome episode of Arcemise Arcade, playing Dragon Age 2. Man, we got a lot of quests popping up over here. We completed the Deep Rose, which ended Act 1 of the game. And we're jumping right into Act 2 here. So, good day to you as well. You may remember we'd helped the Viscount out here.
More and more appealing.
Yeah, I hear you, man. We helped out the Viscount with his son before. His son was a Canary sympathizer, and some bad stuff went down, but we were able to rescue him and kind of say, you know, okay, well, let's just chill a little bit.
Well, you have certainly risen through the rank. Good for you.
Thanks, man. I will take that. You are too, lady. Alrighty. Yes, come back to... Oh, there's Seamus. Hey, Seamus.
Seamus, wasn't it? The Viscount's boy?
You're here rather often, Sirrah Hawk. A good influence, I think. Even by not taking sides, you helped start something. I still accept no blame for defending Kunari, and I don't miss the kinship of the people who oppose what I believe.
Never take the popular stance. I don't like her hate Kunari.
I think they're a headache, but so are many people.
And you've already treated them with more grace than most. Mere existence should not be an offense, no matter how they challenge the Chantry. Not when some of their ideas are so compelling. Another time. When things
yeah, sure. Sounds good, kid.
That corner looks dusty.
Whatever. Let's see. I leveled up some, it sounds like. I'm gonna get some health. Strength and health. Arm and leg day. Let's see. I think it's worthwhile having passive abilities. Yeah. So let's find day to you too. Let's go talk to people. See what's going on. How are things in Guard Town?
I can't do that.
2 seconds, I'm gonna go get somebody that can. You know who we haven't seen in a while? Isabella.
Good luck getting in. I've been waiting all day.
I just came out. right. Oh, you can see Bethany back there wearing Grey Warden clothes. So yeah, the Yeah. sucks what happened to Bethany. And I'll kind of talk over that as I level people up. So a little minor spoilers. Like, obviously I knew that was going to be an outcome when we went in. That's it. It's kind of my favorite outcome. There are three possibilities, with kind of your siblings and the deep roads. There's the scenario we kind of saw, which was I take them down and they get sick. Now, if Anders wasn't with us, they would straight up die down there. Yeah. That's fun. and so obviously you didn't really want to go with that one. Let's just see. Yeah. Like that. But then the other option is if I didn't bring her at all, or if I didn't, you know, if I Carver was in my party and I didn't bring him, what would happen then is that while we're away, Bethany gets found out by, circle mages and is basically sent to the circle tower, and we don't see her like most of the game. And then in Carver's case, if he was with us, he gets, I don't know if he volunteers or recruits himself. He actually joins the Templar. So yeah, but yeah, if Anders isn't with you when you go down to the deep roads and your sibling is, they're gonna die. That's no fun. That I'm gonna petrify. So yeah, it's Dragon Age. It's all about happy, fun family time. Everybody getting along together. That one. And why not? Give me that one. So yeah, either way, like, our family unit just keeps getting more and more fractured. You know, which kind of sucks. It was kind of interesting, like,
coming in here of my own free will feels wrong. Like diddling a sister.
Okay. Yeah. So that's when Aveline stole stuff. Or, not Aveline. Isabella.
Fine day, Sarah.
Yep. So yeah, it's tough being a hawk, not gonna lie. The joining itself, when you become a Grey Warden, like, they kind of hinted at it, it happens like right at the beginning of the first game, is the joining ritual, and they can either die during the joining process, or they might live. And then live out their days as Grey Wardens, which is a whole fun and a half there. But enough of that. Let's talk to Aveline. Hi, Aveline.
It's different here as captain. Feels like family.
Yay!
We'll need to give them answers by tomorrow, captain.
I'll have them. Dismissed.
The Seneschal was particularly vocal.
Dismissed. You'd think the captain of the guard could requisition a Templar or two, but no, that would be demeaning. Can't have them working for the people when Eternity needs a nanny.
Yeah, wait, what? Oh, I'm glad it's not my job.
That's why I remain unimportant. Less pressure. As if the return of the Amels hasn't set Hightown on its ear. As long as it's off its ass. Sure, have your fun. But the coin you poured into Kirkwall tipped what balance there was.
Well, you know, you love it.
I didn't realize I was making it worse by getting ahead.
I'm just harassing you. Although you are a bit like the center of a hurricane. You've changed fortunes for many people, not always for the better.
It happens.
Sounds like you're spreading yourself pretty thin.
There are a lot of people in my charge. Someone has to look out for them.
You guard the guardsmen?
I don't turn people loose like Jevon. There's additional training, doubled patrols. Costs are up, but I've halved injuries. I'll take it and argue with Seneschal Bran later.
Sounds good. You knew Jevon left the mess.
After the last captain, you couldn't have expected this to be easy.
At least I had the guards on my side. Once they understood, they rallied. And those who didn't weren't fit to hold the crest. Stack friends against the enemies. I don't know if I came out ahead, but it's for the better.
Yeah, you love it.
You rouse all you want, but the Aveline I know doesn't regret a second as captain.
They'd have to drag me out of here. And I'm sure some are lining up to try. You among them, I bet. Haven't had much time to follow you around. Not that I need to. I can trust that you at least try to do right. I'm with you if you need me, Hawk. Just say the word.
Yay!
Nothing going on, Hawk. You'd be the first to know if there was.
Yeah, because I'd be causing the trouble. Actually, I was just kind of curious if there was anything in the office.
Fine day, Sarah.
Fine day, indeed. I'd never go down this way. I want to see if there's anything new. Hey, guards. Good job.
I wish the guards weren't so illiterate. I had a report come in this morning that was nothing but a bunch of exes.
Huh. It's like a little throne room. Hey, cool. There's a cup. Very cool. Oh, yeah. Anyway.
Don't touch anything. I've arranged all of the papers.
Alrighty, let's go cause some trouble.
Oh, there you are.
Yep.
I've been looking everywhere for you, Messiah. If only you humans didn't all look the same.
That's racist, but okay. How's it going, man?
We can't all be short and bearded like your people, Bowden.
Indeed. It's quite a shame, really. I came to deliver this to you. The last of the proceeds from all that treasure you found in the Deep Roads.
It seems sweet.
Your friend Varric found a buyer after all, yes? Quite well done.
Wow.
You raced here just to give me this?
Oh, I didn't want to be responsible for so much coin. Just holding that purse was making me sweat. before
you were in a business.
May I simply say how grateful I am that you've allowed my boy to stay in your home. I said I would repay you for saving Sandor's life, and I shall serve you faithfully. It is good to know it is safe.
Yeah, so Bodan and Sandal now live in the Hawk estate.
I didn't ask you to be my manservant, Bodan.
But I owe you a debt, and after what happened in the Deep Roads, I have no other way to repay you. I'll leave you to your adventures. Your mother asks that you return to the mansion when you have a chance.
Hear that, guys? The mansion! Oh, geez, 50 gold. Nice. Yeah, we're in the money now.
I've seen less ostentatious palaces. So this relic you mentioned losing...
You have pretty eyes.
I have pretty eyes.
You elves have such pretty eyes, even the men. It makes me want to pluck them out and wear them as a necklace.
I wouldn't suggest trying.
Oh, I would never try. Not without reason, of course.
Forget I said anything.
Huh. Those kids always get along. I'm gonna try and diversify my party a bit more. I always feel like I kind of get one party and then stick to it and miss out on some stuff, like the banter. Gotta love the banter. Alrighty, so... That would be just appalling! Alright, so, ooh, Hawk Estate, finding home. Yeah, and... Alright, let me check this journal here, because we just got a bucket of stuff. Isabella, Fenris, Anders, plans for the future, finding home. I think I might do that one first. Just because I'm right there. Black Powder Courtesy, speak to the Aeroshock, the Canary compound by the docks, and the Mans of the Kuhn. Continuing Canary presence. Oh, sorry, oh my goodness gracious, oh man. So much work being Hawk. Yeah, so this is our new place. Yeah, I can see our crest is on the shield right there. Isn't it cool? It's awesome. You may have heard it referred to as like the Amel Estate as well. That's our mother's maiden name was Amel. Hawk was our father's name. He was Ferelden. Yeah. Hawk party clothes. Hi, Aveline.
You've settled in nicely. It's just luck and skill. Indeed. Still, more coin never hurts, right? Say, if someone wanted to pass some work your way...
Everybody needs something, but you can always ask me.
What's the trouble?
A thorn in my side, inventing trouble and scaring people. Remember Emmerich, the Templar? He wants your help and some sort of official sanction.
Official sanction?
For his investigation. He's convinced that every random murder in the past few years is connected, and he won't be quiet.
Oh, that was the one guy that was investigating women being murdered, I think.
You don't think it's worth investigating?
I have. He even convinced one of my lieutenants to raid the Dupuy Mansion. Nothing there. You wouldn't believe how much ass I had to kiss after that, bloody hobbyist constable. Why can't he spend his declining years building a boat or something?
Just like NCIS. Are you sure he's wrong?
It should be easy to prove if there are bodies.
Kirkwall isn't the safest place. That doesn't mean everything terrible is related. There's no sense to that. Can't be.
You say that. he had a good start. I'll quiet him down. Nah, he had a good start.
He had some good leads.
Then you won't mind chasing his threads. If it leads somewhere, I'll pick it up. Right now, he's just distracting my men. He's in the gallows. Do what you can. Thanks, Hawk. I'll try not to make a habit of this.
You love it. Yeah, so this is my place. Look at this. Hey, Mom.
It's strange living here again. My childhood home. Now owned by my child. It's not something I could have imagined when I was a little girl staring out this window. I'm still grateful you used your money from the expedition to buy back the estate. I feel like an Amel again.
Don't stir putting on airs.
Just don't go all pompous on me, all right?
I promise. If there's one thing I learned in Ferelden, that good people can be born in a hut as easily as a palace. Honestly, after so many years as a peasant's wife, it feels strange to have nothing to do. But I can't spend the rest of my life mourning Bethany and Carver. They're gone, and I can't bring them back. I guess I just need to start picking you out a suitable husband.
Okay. That's why. It's because she's bored.
Says it reminds him of a mine shaft.
Okay. Hi, Bowden.
If you need any enchantments, I'm sure my boy would be happy to help.
Sweet.
You like the shiny?
Enchantment apparatus. Apparatus. Do-do-do-do-do. Alright.
You like the shiny?
Adventures of the Black Fox. Born Lord Remy Vascal in 863, blessed, the Black Fox was a dashing thief and rogue who went on to inspire so many tales of his exploits that it is nearly impossible to determine today which are true and which are merely fabricated legend. His initial exploits involved ridiculing the tyrannical and powerful Lord Valshevin. After years of terrorizing the Lord's men and foiling his tax collectors, a favorite pastime of Remy's, according to the Elysian commoners, Remy was supposedly betrayed by his lover Servana de Montfort, in some version of the tale of Mage of the Circle, no less, and captured. Wow! The stories all agree that at some point the Black Fox disappeared. He and his fellow adventurers voyaged into the heart of the Arlathan Forest, seeking the sunken city of the elves, and never returned. From The Adventures of the Black Fox by Gaston Gault, 911 Dragon. Sweet. So yeah, let's take a look around. So we got an upstairs. Yeah, nice portraits of people.
That's Mother's room. Oh. I shouldn't intrude.
Oh, fair enough. History of Kirkwall. Nothing important happened in Kirkwall that year. I kid. What the?
Handprints? Was someone swinging on the chandelier?
Sandal swinging on the chandelier. Oh, wait. What was that? Wait.
I should get some curtains.
Some curtains. Yeah, and then there's my room. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Examine.
Isabella seemed disappointed that she didn't find anything worth gossiping about. I think I'll let Sandal empty that.
It's probably just garbage.
What's this? Oh, Anders' manifesto. Again.
Anders is writing a manifesto.
Breakfast, visited Privy, took Mother to Haberdasher. Must have been a slow day.
Hawk's Journal. Finery! I think that's what I'm wearing right now. Technically. I'm just gonna leave that there, actually. Because I never actually wear... It's a fine-looking outfit and everything, but, you know. When I'm out and about, I'm in my gear. Because it's time to rock and roll. So yeah, that's the second floor is my room, and then we got this place. A library. What is that?
Ah, this statue. Wait, where did I get this statue?
Nice.
Sorry, I was expecting treasure, not spiders. Get well soon, love Isabella. Why do I let her drag me into these things? Leather to feather, crossroads of form. I don't even know where to start.
That's some weird books people left in my place. And really it is. It's like they like get stuff for Hawk and then just leave it. Cause again, you gotta remember, this is 3 years after the end of Act One. So we've been in Kirkwall now for quite a while. Storage. Drop that off. Why not? No one uses that. Okay, I'll drop that off. I'll just drop this stuff off. Do 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 do. Belt of the Chastened. We'll see if anyone needs it. I guess I'll take this stuff back. And then I can order potions or grenades. Yep. Mostly grenades. And your potions. I can order elf fruit. And I can order runes. Okay. What's on my desk? Holy goodness. Greetings, I hope this letter finds you well. I've often thought of you in the past 3 years. Without your kindness, my Fainriel would have been long since sold to slavers. Instead, he has thrived and begun to master his magic. But now his nightmares have caught up with him. Neither the Keeper nor the First Enchanter know how to help. I don't know where else to turn. Please come to my home in the Alienage. I will be waiting to speak with you. Thank you again for the compassion you've shown of Fainriel in the past. Sincerely, Ariani. Okay, that was the elven boy who we sent to the Dalish because he's has magic abilities and has really bad nightmares. The Ungrand Ruler, the many people in the city owe you their lives, and as one of them, and I am one of them. When my friends and I were cornered by Templars, you helped us escape. Over the years, most Starkhaven apostates have been captured, but thanks to help of many people, I have remained free. You've done so much for the apostates. If you are moved to do more, please contact Mistress Selby near the docks. She knows many ways you could help more lives. Forever in your debt, Terry of Starkhaven. Cool. A bit of knowledge. Sarah Hawk, years passed. I fell into wickedness and was swept up in the mad ambitions of the blood mage Tyrone. You spared my life at the Blooming Rose, and for many months I wished you had killed me, but I found the Maker's Light in the deepest despair. I now seek absolution. Oh, this was the one woman who was trying to, like, possess us. Tyrone wrote many tomes containing dark secrets she learned from the Fade. She protected them with the demons forged in the very bindings. You must find and destroy these tomes, lest others follow her dark path. I wish I could help you, but the Templars never let me leave my cell. I can only send my prayers. Iduna. So that's a fun one that I have to always remember not to bring Meryl on, because she hates it when I destroy books. A note from Fainriel. Okay, so this is... this mom sent us one, too. It's a Hawk. Life in the Dalish hasn't been easy. Keeper Marathani tries her best, but I don't know what else she can do for me. The younger elves won't accept me, and I often hear them whispering behind my back. The elders have more discretion, but I can see it in their eyes. They're afraid of me. I don't know why I'm telling you this. Sometimes it feels like the only person I can trust. Your friend, Fainriel. Feeling inadequate? Flag flying at half-mast? Does your soldier not stand to attention? Does your dwarf shy away from the deep roads? Come to Jorman's Apothecary and ask for our special sauce. Our special sauce is infused with the essence of 52 herbs. It's completely natural, completely safe, and absolutely effective. You will never feel the same again. Be the man or men... be the man other men want to be. Be the man you deserve to be. Okay. I'm a woman. Messer Hawk, I feel I must apologize. You did what you had to do to turn Keldar over to the guards. You saved my daughter, and I should have been more thankful. This was the guy, remember the kind of serial killer looking dude that, like, was the magistrate's son, or not Seamus, but like that other guy, who was kind of a psycho, kidnapping elves. Leah has been difficult. We left Kirkwall behind, but my poor girl now thinks every man is a monster in disguise. I fear she may never get past this. In your debt, Elrin. Oh, that's unfortunate. A message from Price. Sarah, I'm glad to hear that Ethenril took no vengeance on you for helping me. I surely would have died in her service. Oh, this was the little kid that we helped save. My sisters are both maids now, and I have proven myself an able shepherd, and have been granted 2 ewes of my own to start a flock. Oh, nice. Good for him. I heard you've made a name for yourself in Kirkwall. My hopes for your continued success. Thank you again. Transcribed by the Lady of the House of Price. Strangely official-looking letters. Dear Sir or Madame, I am Lord Ekman, Falk of Starkhaven. I have faith in the Maker and Andraste, his beloved prophet, that I must bring this matter of urgent business to you. Years ago, I served in the House of Seneschal to the royal family of Starkhaven. Sadly, they have been deposed, ousted by a foul usurper. I represent His Royal Highness Prince Kobarian Veo, and the true heir to the throne, and with your help, Maker willing, we will see him wear the crown of Starkhaven once more. His Highness had a fortune of 11,000 sovereigns locked away in the vaults of the Royal Bank of Antiva. With access to this fortune, he can raise an army to retake the throne, but it's too dangerous for His Highness to simply withdraw the funds himself. This is where we require your assistance and discretion. Simply send me the details of an open bank account in Kirkwall, and I will arrange the funds that are transferred to you. My kin will then contact you to retrieve his fortune, leaving you with a hefty award. I must warn you, the Antivans will not consider the account viable if it contains less than 100 sovereigns. Please observe the utmost confidentiality. Yours, Lord Ackman Falk. That is right, kids. Nigerian princes even find their way into fiction. A strange letter from Lotharain. Hawk! Heard you lock out to the free marches. Don't know why you bother, but I suppose it's better than Orlais. They got spiders up there? Big ones? Oh yeah. Couldn't swing a dead cat around here without hitting a giant spider, but the blight drove them off. Maker, dark days ahead. Mark my words. A man can't even cover the blighted land with poisonous traps. Old Barlet. That was one of the guys in the original game. Covered his crops with giant poisonous traps. A message from Lothrain, another one. Dearest Leandra, so this was actually to Mother. I hope you and your children are holding up. I'm so sorry about Carver. I remember the dear boy helping me trap rats in the cellar. The blight has taken too much from us. Thank the Maker for the hero of Ferelden and the Grey Wardens. Things are slowly getting back to normal and most parts of the country, but Lothrain is gone for good. We had hoped to rebuild there, but the blight poisoned the land. It'll take decades for the earth to recover. It may never. Redcliffe is a nice place, and I'm starting to see it as a home. The village saw some trouble during the blight, but it's recovering. Perhaps you could visit sometime. Please write me again, my dear. I wish to hear about your life in Kirkwall. Send my regrets and fond regards to your children. To the children. Your friend, Miriam. Family letters. Artoria. So it's official. I'm a Grey Warden. This is actually from Bethany. Strahd says I'm lucky that the Warden ritual was kept the taint at bay. Not sure if I'd call it luck, but I'm alive. It's been brutal going through this. I have awful nightmares. I close my eyes and hear whispering. Is it real or am I going mad? I'll survive that too. That's my life now, survival, getting through each day. That's what you wanted, isn't it? Tell Mother I miss her. With love, Bethany. Yep. So, yeah, it's a lot of work to catch up on the mail. But I think I'm going to take a quick break there. Thanks once again, everyone, for checking out the video. Please give it a like and subscribe if you enjoyed it so far. And as we dive into Act 2, things are really going to start coming together in this game. I'm going to be explaining a bit more about some of the design elements that I really enjoy in it. I've been kind of holding off on some simply because of spoilers. I like to kind of keep it fresh as we come across them in the game, but you know, we'll see what we can do for that. But with that said, we'll be diving into some of these quests, I'm sure. I'm probably just going to catch up with companions quick, and then we'll be on our way. So once again, I'll catch you next time.